Thank you for the opportunity to have a conversation, because I've now served as representative from the Central Coast area for a few years in the House of Representatives, and have made the decision this will be my last term. I won't be running for re-election. Therefore, I wanted to make sure people understood it, to the best of my ability, to express that I intend to work as hard on the last day I'm in office, mm-hmm. As I did on the first day, that it's not, we're not disappearing. And there's a lot to be engaged in. It's a particularly kind of challenging time mm-hmm. now, as our country has experience, and we're going into an election cycle, so it's kind of part, the contentious parts of that get more known. But there still is a goal that I have, and I believe my constituents deserve it, to mm-hmm. have bipartisan and good work get done. Just today, earlier in the day, coming up here, you try to think of more than one thing to do in a community, and visited Mary Medical Center, which is our largest medical facility mm-hmm. on the Central Coast. And I was instrumental in getting funding when they began their neonatal intensive care unit, NICU, which we wanted to see today how it's doing. It's thriving. I mean, there are a lot of babies born at, locally here, and it's a large employer too. For the said that one of the signature accomplishments during my time in office was to pass the Affordable Care Act, mm-hmm. with all the challenges that it's presented. I believe that California has actually done remarkably well by it, with mm-hmm. our own implementation, which is what the bill was designed to do. We had a broken healthcare system mm-hmm. in the past, and people had a hard time with their getting access to affordable healthcare. Some of those problems remain, but Covered California is actually doing many of the things that the bill was designed to do. I'd like to see those good pieces of mm-hmm. the bill be preserved, and that's in the keeping of, with, I believe, what our country does best. A democracy isn't perfect. It just means that you can improve on things through in a democratic process. Mm-hmm. You pass a law, it's probably not. How do you know what it's going to do until you try it for a while? And then you fix the pieces that are, mm-hmm. are not where they should be and get it better. Medicare is a good example of that.
Right.
It's been modified several times. Social Security has as well. Didn't come out of the box perfect, but we keep working on things. And also, I just have to bring up that we have a constituent who was there with the president when he announced some gun safety measures that he's going to do, because Congress is in such a stalemate mm-hmm. on common sense gun safety. Mm-hmm. And I know it's contentious, but I just, this tragedy we had in Isla Vista, that's who the constituent was there, mm-hmm. who's now working nonstop pretty much on this topic mm-hmm. because of how his life was touched by it. That's kind of, we're not where we should be in that arena as well, I think. And as the president said when he did administrative language, this is not as good as having Congress pass common sense reform. We had a pipeline accident mm-hmm. on Gaviota Coast with a pipeline a company, and the reauthorization of pipeline safety mm-hmm. legislation is due, and I want to make sure that lessons learned from that spill mm-hmm. can be included to have more frequent inspections, to have, it turns out that the technology mm-hmm. for pipeline safety is improved, but this particular company was lagging, mm-hmm. so to have the standards be tightened mm-hmm. in keeping with the industry mm-hmm. Standards. Why did this accident occur in the most poorly managed pipeline company? There are pipelines everywhere. So many veterans live in the Santa Maria Valley. Mm-hmm. They live on the Central Coast. And we discovered in the work that we've done in our congressional offices, we do a lot of work with individuals with issues having to do with a federal agency. And there was a fire that occurred where the records of veterans were stored in Missouri. Mm-hmm. I mean, who would know that that would have such an impact? That has meant that thousands of veterans across the country, but many hundreds here on the Central Coast, lost their records and couldn't prove that they had earned, through their service, benefits. And I introduced bipartisan legislation to do something about that fire. It wasn't the fault of the veterans. Mm-hmm. So we may need to make good with them in terms of getting their benefits accounted for. And there's a way we can do that, piecing together the history. And so it's kind of like house cleaning. Being a nurse and being in Congress, when we were able to address lack of access to health care that's affordable for so many people, we worked a long time, and I was on the committee and subcommittee that put in the hours to make that happen. Not a perfect law, needs to be fixed. Needs to be dealt with, made better, but that is a feeling of satisfaction to me. Being able to have constituents access the congressional offices in San Luis Obispo and in Santa Maria and Santa Barbara, but also through emails and communication, where they feel like there's someone paying attention mm-hmm. to them, who will try, whether successful or not, to address a situation that they feel needs to be addressed, whether that's their own issue, their own grievance or loss that they are not experiencing, or whether it's that they want to band together to address a topic of concern to the community. Dredging a harbor, that you wouldn't think that is such a big deal. Morro Bay hadn't been dredged for years and years. And it was impacting fishing in Morro Bay up in that area. And we got the dredging started. And now if there's a cycle, and it's kind of almost automatic. Folks up in that area wanted a bike path so the kids could ride more safely to school.
Right.
We got legislation passed for bike safety, safe routes to school. The piece of legislation was part of the transportation bill one year. And there's a satisfaction in saying, I didn't think of that.
Right.
I don't live there. I wouldn't have. But the people who do live there really were aware that their kids weren't getting to school safely the way it was before. And that's how, to me, that's how a democracy works, when it works the way it's supposed to. Not always perfectly, again.
Mm-hmm.
And sometimes it doesn't happen, and things get sidetracked, and you have to go back and revisit. And someday we'll have a perfect government, right? No.
Probably not.
We have a lot of things to deal with it when it comes to that. And it's a it really is a privilege when you think about it. Some grubby stuff, too. But
yeah.
There's that in every job.